Thank you, Sarah. Thank you very much. And certainly thank you for attending. I will be making forward-looking statements, and this is the statutory context for those statements that I'll be going through. So why invest in Chariot? Next year, we'll be drilling the Rabat Deep 1 well. It's a 768 million barrel prospect. That's a giant potential. Peel Hunt assigned 17p a share to Chariot in the unrisked case. In the success case, that could go to 87p a share, and we're currently trading at 10p. So clearly there's significant upside and the potential for transformation in our company with that, that prospect. There's even more side associated with that prospect in that Rabat Deep, that's 768 million barrels, we have 10% of it. So 77 million barrels equates to 87p a share in the success case. We have adjoining portfolio that's 1.25 billion barrels of prospective resources in adjacent acreage where we have 75%. So that's some 15 times larger than the prospect that we'll be drilling in JP1. So clearly success in JP1 has the potential for being transformational, but it will also open up an entirely new province that would escalate that potential. We've also been able to build downside protection into our portfolio. What we attempt to do is to undertake zero cost exploration. If we can secure acreage and have third parties pay for the exploration on that acreage, then that's clearly the best risk management capability that you can apply. We have partnered twice on this acreage, first with Woodside, who partnered and paid for the seismic data, and subsequently for E&I, who will be paying for the well. And prior to the seismic that we've just acquired on Kenitra and Mohammedia, we were at zero cost in Morocco. So this downside protection, managing risk, is a key part of what it is that we do. Our cash significantly exceeds our commitments in that we've now satisfied our commitments and we have no remaining debt. Also, we're not a one-trick pony. It's not just Morocco. We have a portfolio in Namibia that has similar characteristics, individual prospect that would be transformational, and an associated portfolio that would escalate that transformation. And we're preparing to drill additional wells over and above Rabat Deep in Namibia in the central blocks, and also in Mohammedia and Kenitra in Morocco. So Chariot, our company, we're an Atlantic margins company. We're looking at high impact exploration. We're elephant hunters. Exploration is a risk business. Searching for giants is the riskiest part of that business, so managing that risk is key, and our focus is on managing that risk through the process. We have an experienced team, and that experienced team are expert in that risk management. We have got the operating capability and the capacity to be able to deliver the potential of that transformational value. It's a small team, which means that we can be nimble, quick, we can move very rapidly to secure acreage, but also we know our portfolio and we're best placed to go through the marketing process for partners and potential partners on that portfolio. And as I mentioned, we have this strong balance sheet. So our strategy is threefold for this risk management: the gold transformational growth, looking for giants, elephant hunting, and we look to create value through access, de-risk, and drilling the portfolio. By access, we secure large acreage positions in new and emerging basins, and we operate those positions. That allows us to control our own destiny, and we've built a broad portfolio that in and of itself is a risk management technique. Once we secure those licenses, we then acquire very large volumes of 3D seismic data. It's exactly what the majors and super majors do, and it's the principal mechanism by which we can go through the process of reducing that technical risk. It's also absolutely essential in that that then allows us to market those assets to those super majors and majors in a way that they would characterize the portfolio if it was their own. So that the application of that technology then allows us to go through into the levered partnered phase. And there are two important aspects about being able to secure a levered partner. Firstly, if somebody is coming into a portfolio and they're paying disproportionately for that portfolio, it describes the quality of that asset. So for example, E&I came and looked at our asset. They usually drill 10 big prospects a year, and they selected Rabat Deep 1 as one of their prospects. And they usually drill 10 prospects a year in the old oil industry environment. We're in a new environment now, there is less exploration, so they'll be drilling of the region of 5 prospects during the course of next year, and this is one of those prospects. So this has had to displace one of the prospects that they have from their portfolio. And given that it wasn't invented there, it has to be a really good asset to be able to displace that asset. So the partnering allows us to get independent validation of the portfolio. Secondly, our aspiration is to undertake zero cost exploration, and we've been wholly successful in that aspiration within Morocco. It is impossible across the portfolio. We haven't developed a mechanism for undertaking exploration that isn't going to cost us anything, but we look to try and get down to zero cost at all those parts. And then finally, and for us, the value creation element is making that transformational discovery. We have to drill wells to make those transformational discoveries, and our aim is to remain an exploration company, so if we make a transformational discovery, it will be the aim to sell that and return the value to shareholders. So we explore, discover, and sell. In terms of our cash and our cash position, we apply and continue to apply rigorous capital discipline across the portfolio. The graph on the left-hand side shows our investments over the last 4 years. We started at $68.3 million. In that 4-year period, we've invested almost $96 million across the portfolio. So at this point, we should be at minus 27.5, but in fact, we're at plus 25. And that's because of how we've been able to go about this zero-cost aspiration. That additional cash has principally come from partnering throughout the portfolio. Of the money that we've raised, 25% has been through the equity markets, but 3/4 has come from partnering and recovering back costs on previous investments. So we have been successful in partnering, and we look to continue to partner across the portfolio. The other really important part is over the last 2 years, which has been a very difficult time in the sector, we have continued to invest in our portfolio. We've continued to acquire large volumes of high-quality 3D seismic data in this downturn period, and that's allowed us to mature our portfolio and develop a portfolio of high-quality opportunities. We also focus our cash on the program rather than overhead. 4 years ago, our overhead was in excess of $9 million. It is now running at less than $5 million a year because we've focused our activity and our team specifically on the investments that we're looking into. So this is the planned activity, and it shows the scale and breadth of our operations across those countries and the assets and the delivery of our strategy. We've got a carried well in Morocco, and it's zero cost in Morocco. We have no remaining work program commitments within the portfolio, and our aspiration is to drill 3 wells in the near term with RD1 already fully funded. And we have the potential for a continuous drilling program on which we'll continue to apply our partnering strategy. Any one of these wells has the potential for delivering transformational value to the company, and any one of these wells, if it's successful, would liberate a very exciting follow-on portfolio that sits behind it. I'll quickly go through our portfolio. Our focus is on the Atlantic margins. That's where experience and expertise of the team sits. That allows us to, because we're in new and frontier and emerging basins, it allows us to learn from along the margin, but also on the conjugate margin. So we're in Morocco, and Morocco is conjugate to Nova Scotia. So Morocco sits here, Nova Scotia is there. Over 800 million barrels of oil equivalent have been discovered in Nova Scotia in exactly the same plays that we're exploring for in Morocco. Similarly, in Namibia is conjugate to Argentina and Uruguay. Discoveries within the Argentinian sector, Uruguay is an area where the super majors and majors have recently entered and committed over $2 billion of investment in that basin that has commonality with Namibia. A number of majors have recently entered into Namibia, and that list will continue to grow. And then our Brazilian acreage that sits in through here, that's conjugate to Ghana and Côte d'Ivoire. And Ghana and Côte d'Ivoire have seen multi-billion barrels of discoveries over the last 10 years, and we're exploring for the same petroleum systems on the conjugate margin. So into Morocco, we have three licenses. Rabat Deep, where we have 10% equity that sits in through here, and then Kenitra and Mahamadia, where we have 75% equity. This acreage is adjacent to onshore gas production and legacy oil production. So this legacy oil production here, we with our partners are chasing exactly that same play system and petroleum system in the offshore. We have acquired, prior to the acquisition of seismic data in Morocco at the beginning of this year, we were at zero cost because of our partnering with Woodside and ENI on Rabat Deep. And this year we acquired 2,000 kilometers of 2D seismic data and 1,000 square kilometers of 3D seismic data in the licenses Kenitra, which we acquired this year, and Mahamadia, which we acquired last year. Our activity going forward is the Rabat Deep 1 well, which I've spoken to. That'll be spudded before the end of the first quarter of next year. And in and of itself, that has the potential for increasing other plays similar to that within the Rabat Deep area. For us, the more interesting part is the de-risking that happens in the adjacent Mahamadia and Kenitra area. In Kenitra and Mahamadia, we've initiated a process to prepare for drill, the EIA, the environmental work that needs to be done, and the other activities so we can follow on from the Rabat Deep 1 well. In terms of the portfolio, this is a seismic section. Essentially, it's a cross-section across the Earth. It goes from west to east, deep water to shallow water, Rabat Deep, where we have 10%, into Kenitra and Mahamadia, where we have 75%. This is the Rabat Deep 1 well, which will be drilled into this prospect. And this prospect, if it's successful, where we have 10%, will de-risk the JP1 prospect, exactly the same prospect type that we're chasing. There are also, these are carbonate plays. There are a number of clastic plays that sit above it, and this is where the bulk of the prospect inventory sits. So again, any success in this will materially and significantly de-risk the neighboring acreage where we have 75% equity. This is 77 net million barrels to Chariot. This is 1,250 net million barrels to Chariot. These are prospective resources. Moving on to Namibia. There have been six wells in the last 3 years in Namibia, and these have now proven two new petroleum systems. And we know as much about those petroleum systems as any within that that province, because we've participated in two of those wells, and we've also have information and evaluation of all of the rest. These new wells have attracted a number of new companies, Tullow, ONGC, Shell, and Galp, and there will be others joining. The acreage position that we have is in the central blocks, which sits in through here. We have a 65% equity and operatorship of that license. Previously, we partnered with Azinam, who paid for an earlier seismic program, and last year, we acquired additional seismic here. We have 6,100 square kilometers of 3D seismic that we've acquired over those licenses. We've now evaluated that and identified five four-way dip-close structures, with Prospect S being the principal target that we're focused on. Prospect S is a 459 million barrel prospect. If, in and of itself, that is successful, it will de-risk 1.4 billion barrels net to Chariot. So again, exactly the same, same process and same theme. As in Morocco, we have now initiated all that we need to do to be able to prepare for drilling. So we've undertaken environmental impact assessment, pore pressure analysis, detailed well engineering so we can scope out and describe what a well would take and how much it would cost within this acreage. We also recently exited the southern blocks, which sits down through here. That was a license where we'd identified high-risk gas potential. We were unable to successfully partner on that So we've exited that license, but we've secured an option with Namcor. The commercial terms of that option are exactly the same as the E&I deal. So we can back in for 10% on any discovery at no cost. So we've been able to not expose ourselves to any future cost on that southern blocks, but still expose ourselves to the upside. This is, again, a seismic line that goes across Namibia. The source rocks, which are proven in the neighboring acreage by wells, sits in here. The reservoirs that we're targeting, which have been proven in the neighboring block, sit through here. And we've got these five four-way dip closed structures. We're targeting to drill Prospect S through here in the fourth quarter of next year. And the intent would be to drill Prospect S with the potential of drilling Prospect W back to back, dependent on the results of the Prospect S drilling. Again, success in any of those wells would be transformational. So moving on to Brazil, last but certainly not least, we were successful in the 11th round of licensing in this basin, and this was the most competitive basin within that licensing round. And the reason for that is this map up on the top left shows South America and Africa, and this is the spreading that's associated with it. And the Barreirense Basin is conjugate to Ghana and Cote d'Ivoire. The industry recognized what we had recognized and entered into the area and and paid over $300 million of signature bonus. And there'll be 10 wells that have been drilled, most of which were committed to within that licensing round. The work program for Chariot was a 3D seismic program, which we completed last year, and we're in the process of completing our description and interpretation of that. Again, here's a seismic line that runs across the acreage. It goes across Chariot's acreage. It goes from shallow water to 700 meters water depth. This is our neighbor, Shell. Shell secured, this license was secured for $72 million, signature bonus, and they've committed to a well. We secured this acreage for less than $2 million, and we have no well commitment. And we're chasing exactly the same geology and petroleum systems. So this is the source rock that both Shell and ourselves are chasing, with reservoirs in the yellow and the green. And we're up dip from Shell, which is always a good thing from a petroleum system. And from the 3D seismic data, we've identified a 200 square kilometer four-way dip closure structure within that acreage. We're in the final throes of completing that work, and then we'll start our partnering process. So in terms of our portfolio, it's drill ready. We've got a large range of plays and investment types. Water depths, we're in deep water, but it's shallow deep water. It's less than 2,000 meters water depth. And we're in new and emerging basins, which means that we've got great commercial terms, and we're chasing big prospects. We're chasing large reserves. So the low cost area that we're in deep water with great contract terms multiplied by large volumes means that these are high margin assets. These are the type of assets that the majors want to be able to bring into their portfolio. So we've built this portfolio, and now working through it. So in summary of the investment thesis, Chariot, we're an elephant hunter, Atlantic margins. We have the portfolio of a major, and we're looking for these giant elements. Much of the portfolio is now drill ready, and we're in the partnering process within them. As a team, we have experience in exploration, appraisal, development, and production, and in deep water. But our focus is on risk management. Exploration is risky business. The type of exploration we do is the riskiest, so managing that risk is the key part of it. And we continue to apply capital discipline throughout what we do. Our cash exceeds our commitments, and in fact, we have no remaining work program commitments. And we have a variety of triggers within our portfolio, and there will be triggers from third parties in acreage neighboring our portfolio during the course of the next 2 years. And our focus will be delivering three wells within the near term across that portfolio, one of which is already funded. And the key element is that success in any part of that portfolio will be transformational to the company. Okay, so with that, open the floor to questions.
Thank you. You're very busy. That was a really colourful presentation. You're not joking when you say you've got lots of seismic data, but I need help with my osmosis. So if you could go back to page 6, which I think is the what we have to look forward to, just so we can keep it up. That's perfect. We can keep it up so people can take it all in to see what the timelines are. I'm interested in this. So you've got Annie, who's come in and is helping you fund Morocco. But what about, you know, you're talking about 3 wells. What about funding for the other 2 wells? Are you going to have to raise some capital, or is it again all about those partnerships coming on board?
Well, the fundamental thing that we're trying to do is to create transformational value. So we have to make discoveries, so we have to drill wells. So drilling those wells is the key and the critical part to it. Without drilling wells, then the whole process is meaningless. At this point, we've been able to undertake our zero-cost exploration model within the Rabat Deep 1. So that's, you know, it's the poster child, and that's what we'd like to replicate throughout everything else that we're doing. In terms of the other wells, the two elements, well, firstly, an important consideration for us is what's the quality of that opportunity? Is this something that we would prepare to invest equity, our equity finance into this? The southern blocks didn't meet that criteria. So because it didn't meet that criteria, we were quite happy to retain an option on it and benefit from anybody else's investment on it. In Namibia, in Prospect S, that passes that criteria. It is a very low-risk, high-quality prospect that sits within it, and we've already partnered on it. So, the investment that we make is what our financing equity is multiplied by the well cost. So at this point, we're going through detailed well engineering to understand what the well cost is, and with our current equity level, we'll be able to determine whether that's something that we do from an equity position or whether we do from a partner position. Prospect S is quite, the principal shallow target in Prospect S is in the same water depth and the same depth below mudline as the recent well that was drilled by Ophir in Côte d'Ivoire, and that was a $20 million well. I don't know whether this will be a $20 million well, we'll do that work and understand it, but that would be $15 million net to Chariot. So that's something that we could, you know, with a lot of pain, fund currently from our position. But again, our preference is to partner. Mm. So we have a data room open on the central blocks, and we're in discussions. So again, those discussions might lead to an E&I type partnership, or they might not. That's something that we'll continue to work through. But in terms of our decision on whether we invest equity finance into Prospect S, it's not one that we need to make yet. So we'll continue the partnering process, we'll continue to apply our strategy, and our aim will be to undertake the zero-cost exploration.
Okay, don't you tell your partner that I call them any.
Okay, right now that's quite all right.
Just the E&I.
I've called them worse things than any, I can tell you. And then within Mahamadiya and Kenitra, they are at a slightly different level of maturity. So in Mahamadiya, we have a drill-ready prospect, LKP1A, which is out there on the right-hand side. But also on the old data, we've identified the Kenitra 1 prospect, but that's extending outside of that 3D, which is why we've acquired the new 3D. Kenitra will have similar characteristics to Prospect S and will have a similar cost profile to Prospect S. So again, if it's a $20 million.
So, in a nutshell.
In a nutshell, our preference is to partner, but if these prospects have the right quality, then that's something that we will invest our equity into it.
Lovely. Thank you, Larry. Right, questions from the floor, please.
In terms of the equity split, what's the percentage of the split that you have in terms of institutional or private?
In terms of our shareholder base, it's something slightly less than 15% is owned by the board and senior management. There's 35% which are in institutions and high net worth individuals, and then it's about 50% that's with retail in the private investor sector.
Okay, thank you. Next question, please.
Thank you for the presentation. In Brazil, the shallow deep water, 2,000 meters, what does that cost to drill?
We haven't defined the prospect, so we haven't gone through that process.
Yeah.
So, and I mean, on the seismic line, it all depends where the target is.
Right.
So if it's a deep target, it'll be more expensive than a shallow one. So once we've completed that evaluation, we'll then take it through to that type of evaluation analysis. But one thing that has dramatically changed over the last 2 years is just the cost structure within the industry, and this is where we've really been able to capitalize on seismic data. Seismic data costs a fifth of what it did 3 or 4 years ago, and we've acquired large volumes of data in Brazil and in Namibia and in Morocco. We are on the seismic contractors' Christmas list because we're one of the very few companies that have been investing in the way that we have. But the same has happened with exploration drilling wells. So the wells that were drilled in the earlier campaign in Namibia, these were $70, $80 million wells. So those wells, you would expect them to be drilled between $20 and $30 million. So the cost structure, the amount of investment in exploration has decreased. The cost structure has responded to that lack of investment, and that is absolutely decreased as well. So I don't know what the answer is, but I'll know when we've completed the work.
Can you just give us some feel, those near-term triggers that you've got there, in looking at a blue sky in the best possible world, if you had to find a fantastic partner, how much money would you need to go through over a number of years? I'm not giving you a time limit.
Again, it really will be a function of what our partner, how successful we are at partnering. So if we can replicate the full carry from ENI, with ENI it was all the back costs and the full carry through the forward program, then we don't need any money because it's zero cost going forward. But it really will depend on what the nature of those deals are. So.
Quickly, can we go to page 7, very quickly?
Yes.
That phrase, Christmas list, came up. Here you've got all these lovely areas which are conjugate to each other. If you could add a territory, a continent, a shelf, a plate to your Christmas list, what would it be?
We're focused on the Atlantic margins. We'll stay in the Atlantic margins. We're currently trying to secure an additional license area, but I can't specify where that is or whether it'll happen or not. So. So with the conveyor belt, we're trying to keep that conveyor belt going. So we've now partnered on Rabat Deep. Somebody else is operating Rabat Deep. We've now got the capacity to take on another operatorship. So we're trying to add on an asset to the other side of the conveyor belt.
Lovely. Larry, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.